Hello friends, my name is Pushkar and welcome to next video of Angular 7 series. In this video, we are going to discuss that how we can validate template driven form. And in previous video, we already discussed about the what is a template driven form and how we can use template driven form in our application. And also we created separate videos for reactive form. So if you do not have any idea about those things, please go and watch my previous video. So before we start, please subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so you will get a notification of my latest video. Okay, so let's first discuss the theoretical part, that how we can validate particular element or forms. So in the template driven approach, if you want to validate that particular form, then Angular use few directives and HTML attributes to validate. HTML attributes like required, mean length, max length, and pattern. So once we do the practical, that is a much more clear that how we use HTML5 attributes and the directives to validate particular form. And those attributes are not a part of Angular. Those are built-in HTML5 attributes. Okay, so keep that in mind. Those are not a part of the Angular. Those attributes, required mean length, max length, pattern, are part of, or they, those are built in into the HTML5. Okay, yeah. And suppose we want to track that particular element is valid, invalid, or like suppose we test that particular element or not. So for that, Angular provide the different states for particular form control or particular form element. Okay, those are mainly few states which we generally used. Okay, those are valid, invalid, pristine, dirty, untouched, and touched. So valid, this property returns true if the element contains are valid, and false otherwise, right? It means that that particular element is valid, then it will, this property gives true, otherwise it will gives false. Invalid, if that particular form control or particular form element is invalid, then it gives true, otherwise it will false. Pristine, this, like suppose we define or we assign that particular property default to value, like it's a suppose blank, and we not changed anything, then it is true. And if once we changed any value or we change that particular form control or particular element, then it is become a false. Okay, and dirty is means that we changed anything onto that particular form control or particular element. Untouched, it means that till yet we not touched that particular form control or element. Okay, and once we touched, it becomes a false. And just opposite touched, it means that we touched, if we touch that particular element, then it gives true, otherwise it will default, it is false. Okay, so once we do the practical, those states are more clear. We'll do the practical for those all states, so don't worry about that. Okay, and in the previous video we created one application inside, we inside that we used template driven form. This application we created, this form we created, and inside that we have a few form control or form elements: of name, last name, website URL, email, and also we created nested form for street, city, state, zip, right? And we are using this reference variable here, right? And to exploit this ng form, to use this ng form, right? Okay, and you can see that my server is already running, and we can see that this is running onto the 4200 port, and this form we created, right? And here this is form, and if you type anything, you can see the values here. And in this video we will saw that how we can assign the default values to this form, and also how we can validate that particular first name is required, and we cannot enter anything, any special character apart from number. We just allow only to the characters or numbers. Then how we can validate, how we can apply particular pattern for that, how we can apply email validation. So we are going to discuss about those things in this video. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so first of all, that how we can assign the default values to this form. For that, first of all, we need to create one object or one model onto the component class side. This is exactly the model which we are using onto the our form, or which we are attaching that this particular object to the our this form. Okay, so let's create one variable for that, and right now I'm using any for this, right? So just I'm doing a copy paste because this is to just save the time, right? So we can use this object using a two-way data binding and using ng model. Okay, so let's use that ng model, and we need to assign those values, that first name for that. Okay, f name and contact form dot f name. And if you save this, or let's you can see it's a compiling. Once the compilation is successful, we can see the value of that object to the that particular object value is assigned to that form element, right? You can see here. So let's do the for the remaining elements as well. This last name, this for this is a name, this is website, this is email, and for address we are using a nested form. So let's do that for as well. Use address dot street, street, this is city, next is for state, and we need to give an address here, address here as well, address, or copy this. Okay, and last one is zip. By that way, we assign that particular complete object to our form, right? It means we are setting that to assigning the default values. It's a you can see it's a compiled successfully, and you can see that all the values are we assigned, right? Now next is that how we can apply particular validation for this first name. So as we discussed that Angular use directives and few HTML5 attributes, right? So we are using a node module this directive as well here, and also we are using ng form directives. Now we need to apply required validation. So we are going to use that HTML5 attribute required. Okay, this one, yeah, required. Now how we can check that particular field is valid or not, right? So in previously we in this video previously we saw that there is a different state. So we can use those state to check that particular element is valid or not. Okay, so let's do that as well. Okay, now we have created that particular reference variable. You can see at the top this reference variable f dot form dot controls dot f name dot valid, right? Okay, now save this and go to browser. Yeah, you can see that, right? And you can see there is a no error in console, right? So default we assign this but value, so this is true. And if we remove this, you can see that this is false, means this we applied the validation that particular first name is required. Okay, now suppose we want to add one more thing, that mean length for that particular input element, then how we can do that mean length. Okay, so suppose we want to apply that to 12 characters are required for that, or suppose 10 characters are required, at least 10 character. Okay, then how we can do that? Okay, you can see that default is false because at least 10 character is required for this particular input. Yeah, so this that's the reason it is default false. And once you enter more, then you can see that it is true, right? So for now, I'm giving it 3. And next is that how we can add that that only we can enter only the number and only characters, special characters and others are not allowed. Then we can use HTML5 attribute pattern. Okay, and we have one pattern that we are allowing only A to Z in capital as well, or 0 to 9 only. Okay, so let's apply that as onto that particular control or that particular element. Okay, save this and go to browser, and you can see that default is true. And once we if we enter any special character, you can see that it is now invalid, right? And this is a one way which by that way we are accessing that particular valid property, that particular input element is valid or not. Okay, there are so many other ways by that way we can check that is valid or not. Okay, so we are going to explore those things as well. There are some short syntax as well. So here we are using this particular reference variable dot forms, and also we can access this using direct reference variable, this reference variable dot controls. Okay, it will also give the same result. And here we are giving controls, so that is clear to us. And this is form dot control. Save this and go to browser. And now we can see that this is also true and this is also true. Let's put up some BR so that is much more clear for us. Save this. Yeah, here you can see that form control, this is true, and this is controls, means that if we use those are the different ways to access that particular state, nothing else. Yeah, so if you make it invalid, then you can see that both values are false. There are the one more way to access this, so let's explore that as well. So here we created that for this particular input element, we can create one reference variable as well. Okay, so let's create reference variable f name and give that here model and g model, this model. Yeah, okay. And we can use this reference variable as well. Reference, okay. And we can use that f name directly, and we can give here f name. Okay, save this. So those are just a different ways to access that particular form is valid or not, nothing else. Okay, so keep that in mind. So here you can see that if we use form control true, this is also true, this is also true, right? So those are the just a different ways to access, nothing else. Yeah, hope this is clear. There are the three we added by mistakenly at extra. So there are the mainly three ways to access the state. Right, and if you make it like suppose if you enter any special characters, you can see all those three values are changed. Now other states also we discussed about, in those different states are also available, that invalid, pristine, dirty, untouched, touched. So let's do the practical for those things as well. Okay, next we are going to discuss that invalid. invalid. Okay, and we are going to use just only reference variable one, invalid. Yeah, and next we have pristine. Pristine. Next we have touched, untouched. Touched. Next is untouched. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth. So those mainly those states we use to for that particular control, form control or particular element. Yeah, hope this is clear. Now save this and go to the browser, and you can see that those are compiled successfully. And you can see that, right? This is a first valid one. Or let's add one more br here, so that is more clear. Yeah, you can see that for valid default, this is valid because we have something inside this form control or this particular element. And invalid is false because this is valid, right? So that's the reason it is invalid is equals to false, right? And next is pristine. Pristine for PRIST. Okay, I did the spelling mistake. Pristine, PRISTINE. Pristine. Yeah. Save this. Yeah, you can see that default is valid, is true because we have something valid onto this particular form control. Invalid is false because this is valid, right? So it means that invalid is false. Pristine means we have some default value, or like we can say that we not change anything onto this particular input yet. Okay, and next is touched. It means that we not touch that particular value yet, right? Pristine. Also one more we have is dirty, so let's add dirty below to the pristine. So we can see that difference between the pristine and dirty as well. Pristine means that we not change the value yet, or dirty it means that we change the value. Okay, you can see that here pristine is true means that we not change the value yet, right? And dirty is false because we changed, right? If we changed, then it becomes a true. So you can see here, and also that there is a touched equals to default is false because right now we not test that particular input control. Or untouched equals to true because this is untouched. Now if you touch that particular form control, you can see that. You can see that, right? Touched means we touch that particular input element. That's the reason it becomes a true, and untouched equals to false, right? Hope this is clear. But pristine is still true and dirty is false because we not change the value. So once you change the value, you can see the difference here, pristine and dirty, right? Suppose I'm changing that particular Pushkar Sony, okay? And you can see that pristine become a false because we change the value, and dirty is become a true, right? Hope this is clear about the valid, that gives a valid if that particular form control is valid. Invalid, it means that that particular input element or form control is invalid. Next, pristine, if we not changed anything onto that particular input element, whatever the default value, like it's a blank or like default we assigned the some values And if we not changed anything onto that particular value, then it will give true. And once we change that value, it will give the false. Dirty, if we change any value, then it will give true. Otherwise, it will false. Touched, if it touched that particular input element or form control, then it will give true. And default is false. Untouched, it default is true, and otherwise it will false. Yeah. So hope this is clear about the touched, untouched, dirty, pristine, invalid, or valid. Yeah. And now next is that how we can disable that particular this submit button if this particular form is invalid. Okay. So for that we can use a disabled property. Here this is our submit button, so we can use disabled property here. And if that particular form is invalid, is not valid, then we can disable this form, right? So this f dot valid, yeah, save this. And you can see that default this form is valid, so that particular submit button is enabled, right? And once if you add something onto the special characters, you can see that this is disabled. Now next, that how we can validate email. So for that we can use email attribute onto that particular input element or form control. This is also an HTML5 attributes. Okay. And to check this, what we can do, we can use reference variable, and we can create a reference variable for this email as well. Okay. So let's create a reference variable hash email and just assign that particular model to this. Okay. Save this. Right, it's a true default because we have a valid email address. And if you remove this part, you can see that this is false, and you can see that this gets disabled. And if you add valid email address, you can see that this is right valid, and this is submit button is enabled. Yeah, hope this is clear about the how we can validate that particular form. Okay, now how we can access that particular form onto the component class side. So let's do that practical for that as well. So we can use a view child for that part. Okay, and how we can use view child. So for that we have one decorator, that is view child, and we can give a ng form, and we are using the form, yeah. And inside the view child we can give the reference whatever that we have created for this particular form. Okay, this form f, right, we are created here, so we just need to give reference of that. About the view child in detail we will discuss in the separate video, so don't worry about that part. Yeah, right. So we can use this to access. We can subscribe this onto the ng on it. This dot data dot value, or we can use form dot value changes dot subscribe. And here we can use data and save this. So if you change anything, you can get those values onto the component class side, right? By that way, we can access this particular form onto the component class. So hope this is clear, and that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll discuss that how we can add custom validation in template driven form. Yeah, hope you like that particular video, and that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so you will get a notification of my latest video. Yeah, thank you.